Hi guys, welcome to UPSC Cloud. Once again, in the lecture series of Vision IS Polity by Asis sir, this was just an attempt to make you available the notes of Vision IS so that it can help in the self-study. So in the previous lecture one, we have completed up to the here, up to this part. Now let's next part. After the sir recommendation, I had made some value-added material in my notes. The value materials also I will make you dictate that materials. So what was that? First, 8 major committees and some other minor committees were constituted. Major committee and some other minor committees. Among all, most important committee was drafting committee, set on August 29, 1947. It was this committee which was entrusted with the task of preparing draft of the new constitution. Dr. B. R. Ambedkar, Bhimrao Ambedkar, chairman. He was an architect of the constitution of India, fought for repressed classes as well. He was an eminent jurist, economist, politician, and social reformer also. The 8 members, first Alawardi Krishnaswamy Iyer, one of the main member. N. Gopalaswamy Ayyanagar, he was a proficient leader of Rajya Sabha and member of cabinet as well. K. M. Munshi, member of Constituent Assembly of India, Minister of Agriculture and Food of India, also the governor of Uttar Pradesh. Mohammad Sadullah, Prime Minister of Assam, British India, chairman of Guwahati Municipality in 1919 and Minister in Charge of Education and Agriculture of Assam from 1926 to 1934. B.L. Mittal replaced Madhav Rao on the drafting committee due to ill health. D.P. Khetan, he was proficient member of drafting committee. He died in 1948 and then T. Krishnamuchari become the part of the committee. So this is the value added. Now come to the lecture part, lecture second. Sir had wrote the simple formula, simple majority, first formula, simple majority, not less than 50 upon 100 into present voting member. What is absolute member? Not less than 50 upon 100 into total member of the house. Effective majority, not less than 50 upon 100 into total membership of house minus vacancies in the house. A special majority, A, not less than 2/3 into present and voting member plus absolute majority. Now here comes parliamentary system and presidential system. In parliamentary system, executive is part of legislature. Okay, in parliamentary system, as MPs are the MPs are the part of COM, Council of Nation. Executive and legislature are completely different bodies in presidential form of government. So these are presidential and these are parliamentary. So black are parliamentary and blue are. In parliamentary, Council of Minister represented by PM is the true executive and president or monarch is the head of the state, not having much real executive power. Means that president is just like a nominal head. That is, PM is the head of government and president is the head of the state. President is real executive head of the state as well as head of the government / executive and secretary in the presidential system. Now let's come to the next page. In parliamentary system, ministers are from parliament only, or if not, they have to become member within 6 months. Okay. In president, मिनिस्टर प्रेसिडेंट मिनिस्टर आर नॉट द मेंबर ऑफ लेजिस्लेचर एंड प्रेसिडेंट चूज हिज टीम ऑफ मिनिस्टर फ्रॉम द अमोंग द सिटीजन एट लार्ज जस्ट लाइक इन अमेरिका. हियर काउंसिल इन पार्लियामेंट्री काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू पॉपुलर हाउस दैट इज लोकसभा एंड द पार्लियामेंट इन जनरल. दैट इज दे आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल वट एवर दे आर डूइंग दे हैव टू रिस्पॉन्सिबल अबाउट दैट. हियर प्रेसिडेंट एंड हिज मिनिस्टर आर नॉट रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू लेजिस्लेचर. In parliamentary system, we get to see more accountable executive even if its stability is compromised. Presidential system put greater focus on the stability of government but less accountability. Okay. Indian, now let's see Indian parliamentary system and British parliamentary system. It is federal. It is unitary. Okay. In India, we are republic, that is we have elected head of the state, but in British parliament they are monarchy, that is the head of the state is hereditary. We have a written constitution where constitution is sovereign. In British unwritten constitution where parliament is sovereign. Upper house of Indian parliament is the house of representing the interest of the state called council of the state, where upper house in British parliament is not representing the states. Here, sir, I written a question. In India, judiciary is inferring in the work of executive. Is it possible that in future Supreme Court will make law in India? This question you have to think and write. Nature of Indian federal system. Some people says India's constitution is federal, and some believe it is quasi-federal or it is federal with unitary bias. However, Supreme Court interprets that federalism is the basic nature of Indian constitution. How India is federal? Written constitution. A federal constitution necessary is a written constitution. Since we have written constitution, it supports the case of federation. To prove India is federal, Constitution has clearly divided the power between center and the state, and since both these government derive their power directly from Constitution, none is inferior to other. In fact, both are coordinating bodies, each supreme in its own area. Okay, rigidity of Constitution. Federal Constitution has to be rigid, at least in important areas. Since Indian constitution is rigid, at least in areas especially relating to distribution of power between the center and state, it makes point for India being called federal. Authority of court. A federal system setup must have a judicial setup which is independent of center and state, not only to resolve the dispute regarding power distribution between center and state, but also see both the government to work in respective area only, not encroaching each other jurisdiction. Okay, so next page, Article 368, sir, I wrote in just because the question in discussion came there before that the parliament has not the power to amend the constitution, then only the Article 16 added as a procedure to amend. First, A. Article 54 and 55, election of president. Sir has told many things about this. B. Article 73, extent of executive power in union. Article 62, extent of executive power in state. Article 241, high court in UTs. To chapter 4 judiciary of part 5 talks about union provision of Supreme Court. Chapter 5 of part 6 talks about the state provision of Supreme Court. These are the important articles. Chapter 1 part 2nd center and state relation, legislation relation, law making relation, schedule 7, list 1, 100 list, current and originally 97, in this 66 and currently 61 and original 50 47 and currently 52. रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ स्टेट इन पार्लियामेंट, आर्टिकल 368, रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ स्टेट इन पार्लियामेंट, दिस आर ऑल्सो ए पॉइंट विच यू विल गेट इन पॉलिटी बुक, एंड आर्टिकल 368, सुप्रीमेसी ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इन फेडरल कॉन्टेक्स्ट, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इज बाइंडिंग ऑन सेंटर एज वेल एज स्टेट, नाइदर सेंटर अलोन नॉर स्टेट अलोन कैन अमेंड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एटलीस्ट इन इम्पॉर्टेंट एरियाज, फाइव मेजर एरियाज वेयर सेंटर एंड स्टेट नीड टू एक्ट इन कोऑर्डिनेशन टू अमेंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन आर, इन दिस फाइव कैटेगरीज अमेंडमेंट इन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फर्स्ट पास बाई पार्लियामेंट बाई स्पेशल मेजोरिटी दैट इज टू थर्ड ऑफ द प्रेजेंट मेंबर एंड वोटिंग एंड एब्सोल्यूट मेजोरिटी देन एट लीस्ट 50% ऑफ द स्टेट लेजिस्लेशन अप्रूव इट बाई सिंपल मेजोरिटी देन ओनली इट विल बी सेंट फॉर प्रेसिडेंशियल असेंट, बट इन अदर सिचुएशन पार्लियामेंट कैन अमेंड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एज इट्स ओन लेवल. ओके, दिस आर हियर अप टू लेक्चर 2. वी विल सी लेक्चर 3 in distinguishing feature of Indian federal systems, and these are the 5 points. These are the 5 points up over there where the center and state need to enact the acting coordination to amend the constitution. So thank you.